watching Unapologetic Filmmaking and Dope Ish.
All right, then. So, I guess we can go ahead and go on to the next topic then. And it's going to be the power up.
The power up. It's time for the power up, people.
Okay.
All right. So, again, I don't know who made this one up, but people in the startup world, the tech world, they know this. You know, you got to know this. It's fail fast, fail cheap. And I saw that, and we'll have to post this picture. It's basically, this picture is a bicycle with square wheels, you know what I'm saying, which is dope.
Mm-hmm.
And basically what that means is, in any business, you should have failure, especially in the film business. Like, you really should have failure. If you don't have any failure, that means that you're not pushing an envelope. That means that you're not challenging yourself. That means that you're just regurgitating whatever the guy or girl in front of you was doing filmmaking wise, you know what I'm saying? Same thing in tech or startup. It's like, you should be doing something that's pushing the envelope forward, which means that there's bound to be failure because it's uncharted territory. But if it's just smooth sailing, that means that you got it way too damn easy, you know? So that being said, I actually saw this really cool video. I sent it to Alex. He didn't watch it.
I was very busy. He was like, hey, look at this video. I'm like, oh, okay.
Listen, it was called Famous Failures. And I'm not sure who made it, but it's a motivational video. So I felt like it fit right in. And this is one of the quotes. It says, he wasn't able to speak until he was almost 4. His teachers said he would never amount to much. Guess who that was? Albert Einstein. I don't know if you see that, but that's Albert Einstein.
Okay.
I think I need to get a 7+, maybe. Just 7. So they can see it, you know what I'm saying?
I don't think that's the case.
Hey, I'm just saying that.
We just post a picture. That means you just want to get the 7+. That's all that.
No, actually, I don't, and that's bad because I love Apple products, but when I saw the 7+, I felt like it was just not worth the buy. I'm waiting on the 8 to come out.
That's something like that's sacrilege, man. Like, I know, what you talking about,
but,
man?
You know, but listen, man, listen. I am all about functionality. I can't pay no extra money if it's not doing anything to really truly help me.
Really?
Yep.
No extra money on nothing?
No, hell no. Man, you know it takes me forever to buy stuff any damn way, because I'd be like, well, hold on. Let me make sure.
Well, it does take you a very long time to narrow something down, though. So, okay.
Because I'm picky, man. It's got to be perfect for me. You know what I'm saying? There's always going to be some dope stuff out there, but it's got to be perfect for me or for what our needs are.
Okay.
All right. So then that's Albert Einstein, people. I mean, mm-hmm. like, so his teacher said he would never amount to much. That's a lot of much that he amounted to.
Oh, yeah. Well, especially since his theories and everything still hold true to this day. They still use that. And, you know, so.
Right.
Yeah. He changed the world.
He changed the game, people. Mm-hmm. Okay. Famous failures. Okay. Then the next one is, was demoted from her job as a news anchor because she wasn't fit for television. You know who that is?
Mm-mm.
Oprah Winfrey.
Mm,
damn
really?
People. Damn,
really?
Damn it, people. She wasn't fit for television, I guess.
Really?
I don't know.
But say what now? Because what now? She has her own network.
Own? Yeah.
Yeah, own network. What she's worth.
Not on
the billions.
Billions, right. Not billions. Only is she not fit for television, or she is fit for television, she owns her own station, people.
Full network.
Yeah, oh yeah.
It's a network.
That's crazy.
It's a network. So yeah.
So yeah, so she wasn't fit for television. So some people would say that that's a failure because she was demoted, but she moved on up.
Like, well, yeah, it just shows, like, you know, just perseverance. Period.
Right.
You know, it's like evidently these people literally were following whatever that was in their heart.
Right.
And they kept going.
Right.
Even though, like, they, like I said though, right? You can keep hearing no. All it takes is one yes.
Mm.
It just takes one yes.
Already.
And
you
then kick
know.
That door down,
yep.
you know?
Yep, yep. So, man, please don't listen to the naysayers. Haters going to be haters no matter what.
Yeah.
All right. So, then I'm going to do this last one. There was quite a few of them, but do this last one, which I thought was kind of, like, really, really ironic. It says, got fired from the newspaper for lack of imagination and not having no original ideas. You know what that is?
Mm-mm.
Walt Disney. Hot damn.
That's pretty funny.
And to this day, his company is currently in possession of the franchise. Bam.
Yeah, slowly for surely. We need to be more careful about them because evidently they almost like they're trying to rule the world.
Hey, man, you know what?
I'm just being honest. Like, yeah, literally. Yeah. I mean, like, dude, you got Walt. I mean, all right, you got the Disney Company. They own
Marvel.
They bought Marvel, ESPN. I'm like,
dude. I didn't know they own ESPN.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So, literally, you can go through a list of some of the stuff and some of the sub companies.
I wish my lack of imagination would allow me to.
Well, yeah. Oh, well, yeah, I know. That's what I'm saying. Like, you know, and that's crazy in itself, though. So, but yeah, like I said, really just perseverance. You know what I'm saying? And still, like I said, all it takes is just that one. It takes that one.
Yeah. I mean, you know what the thing is, I was actually reading a book again, and I think Walt Disney's brother was the one that handled a lot of the financial things and making sure that, you know, because Walt was a dreamer, you know what I'm saying, and his brother was the businessman. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I just thought that was like...
No different from Steve Jobs.
Right,
Steve Wozniak, you know?
Right, yeah, he actually built the freaking Mac.
Well, yeah, but like I said, but also, it's no difference, too, from how Miyazaki, you know, we talked about, saying the producer.
Right.
I'm screw his name up, so I'm not going to say it, though. But like, you know...
Go ahead, try it, man.
Nah, I'm going to screw his name. Nah, I have to look it up. I don't want to. But I remember watching an interview, and they were talking about how he even found Miyazaki. And pretty much, like, he was actually he worked for like a magazine paper, and like they actually review stuff, whatever, like that. And he saw his work because he was working on a few different like films. You know, so like, oh, like, who did the storyboard, stuff like that. Oh, it was a Miyazaki guy, and he was like looking at some of his artwork, some of his own stuff.
But hold on, like people, like if you don't know who he is, like tell him the films that.
Oh, how Miyazaki is. Well, he's the person that created Spirited Away. Mm-hmm. Let's see, Princess Mononoke.
Howl's Moving Castle.
And then on top of that, too, a lot of people don't know this, too, though. The guys from Pixar, when they hire new workers, they make them watch all his films.
What?
Yeah, that's correct. So,
well, you know, they say that he is the Asian Walt Disney.
Right.
Which is crazy.
Like, right. Exactly.
That's a hell of a combination.
So the lead person of Pixar, you know what I'm saying?
And that is...
Okay, just
damn
stop.
It.
Exactly.
Damn
stop.
It. I know it.
I know. So, So while you thinking about it, I'm gonna let you know this though, like, because this is the thing, right? I actually saw an interview of it, and he was talking about how, like how they were doing their films. That's what they based their stuff off was Miyazaki.
That's crazy.
Literally, like you know, seeing the pacing, everything, what he was doing. So, like,
damn it, it's killing me.
It's so, okay, so I know. Just look him up, right? That's why you got smartphones, right?
Yeah.
So,
but I got the book though.
You got the book?
I read the book.
Yeah.
Well, when I say read people, I mean I listen to, because...
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, you listen to Audible, right?
Audible, yes. Yeah,
even though we don't have no
sponsorship
or anything.
They need to hook us up.
I know, right? But anyway, though, but the thing was this, though, about that. Like, he talked about, like, hey, that was, like, hey, you work for us, you watch these films. These are
Ed
the base.
Ed Catmull.
So you watch
Ed Catmull.
Oh, okay. So good job. You found him. So, but with that being said, though, they talked about that literally. It was like, oh yeah, it's like they talk about, like, you have to watch these films, like, from Folcoroso to it's a few other ones. Like, you know what I'm saying, that he's done with Totoro, Kiki's Delivery Service, like all these films.
I think I've seen all of those.
You haven't seen all of them? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. And you watch them whenever it's like, wow, and it's like, yeah, so that's where they took the cue from. And then that's when we start doing tour stories, stuff like that, though. Even though we went sidetracked, whatever, like that. But back to, like I said, you know, but it always, back to him, it was that, that producer found him and was boosting him up.
Right.
And he was working on him on the side. And then it was like they did their own thing, and then they made their first feature film together. And it's history from there. Now you got Studio Ghibli.
Right.
Ghibli.
Yeah. That, it'd be interesting to see what his failures were.
Yeah.
I mean, just because... The thing is, again, like, if you're...
Oh, you know, he's coming... I'm sorry. He's coming out of retirement.
Oh, yeah, I did hear that.
He's coming out of retirement.
Is he retired and he's coming back? Man, you can't, look, when you got the juice, you can't retire, man.
Well, I think it's one of them type of things where it's like... I think them type of people cannot retire.
They can't.
I think, like, you may leave for a few years.
Right.
And now it's like, I'm back. Like, it's like, hey... Because, like, you know, you're in the grind for so long... And it's like,
you don't know how not to.
Right. You know, and that's one. But then it's like, all right, I'm going to step out. I'm going to step back. And on top of the two, he's old.
Right.
Like, he's old.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So it's
what
like,
are you going to do?
But I mean
he's going to retire. What is he going to do, really?
That's the thing, though, right? And it's like, so he left, and then now he came back. You know what I'm saying? So now he's about to do another film.
I see my dream, not dream, my goal is to die on set. Dude,
Jesus,
like,
man.
So, man, listen. I'm like, dude, I'm never retiring, man.
You're
going to
die on set?
I'm going to die on set. Like,
The problem is this, right? This is the problem, right? So if you were to die, this is the problem. So as you get older, like, what if you just take cat naps all the time? And so you don't even know, you're dead. It's like, oh, you're going to say take five or something, right? And it's like, you literally just over there, and it's like, all right, dad, let's go. And it's like, we don't even know how long he's been dead. He's just been there, you know? Or literally, like, you know, we say cut, take, whatever. And if you're known for always, like, staying after, like, you like to stay after.
Yeah.
And you just sitting in your chair. And you come back dead. The next morning, like, man, he's dedicated. You know what I'm saying? And no, but you just passed away, man.
Yeah. But that has to happen, man, because I'm never retiring, dude.
You never retire?
The closest that I will probably get to retiring will be writing.
Really?
Yeah. That's it. I can't, man. I remember this past week or whatever, I took a break. Mm-hmm. It was awful.
Really?
It was terrible, dude. Like, I was just
what'd
like,
you do?
Nothing. I watched a couple movies, but I just kept feeling like I was doing something wrong. Like, dude, like, I had stuff I could be editing. I got stuff always. And I just felt like I was doing something wrong. I was like, dude, I'm never retiring. I know it. I'm never retiring.
Never retiring?
I'm never retiring, dude. Which means you're never retired.
Oh, man. Listen, man. This is the thing. I already had my retirement planned out and everything.
Hey, man, listen.
I had my retirement planned out. But see, the problem is the...
What you going to do?
Listen, this is the thing, all right? See, my retirement is planned out after I get certain movies made. So, like, once these movies are made... But my thing is, I don't know when they're going to get made. So, right. Then once they're made...
So, we're going to hold out as long as...
I know, right? That's the thing, right? But, like, you know, but my thing is this, though. Like, eventually, I probably won't retire. I mean, I'm going to do something.
You can't, man.
I'm going to do something.
I don't retire. You can't retire.
Yeah, I understand that. I do. And I understand what you're saying, you know? I mean, but you still got to pass it on, man. You got to pass the torch
on. I'm going to pass it on, and I'm going to, like, run that way, and I'm going to go this way.
Keep going that way?
Yeah, man. Listen, man, we're going to branch off.
All right, then. So, you're going to be the Hayao Miyazaki.
That's right.
You never retire, huh?
That's right.
Die on set. So are you gonna get a statue made of yourself?
No, I ain't doing all that. That's crazy.
Put yourself in a statue?
So no.
You just on set, you're already sitting in the chair, you inside of it. That's gross.
That's weird.
That's gross.
That's weird. Look my eyeballs that can follow people like I got Mona Lisa eyeballs.
That's the worst, yeah, man. No, that is the worst. But all right then, so that's a good power up though.
Yeah,
you know
what
I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So fail fast and fail cheap. Meaning, hold on. So I don't know if we got this the fail cheap part.
Right.
Fail fast and fail cheap really means if you fail early on in the beginning, you lose less money.
Yeah, of course.
If money at all.
Yeah.
But if you are like just not trying anything or whatever and you fail while you're like at the height, it might be a little more disastrous.
No, ain't no mic. It's going to be more disastrous.
Right.
You know, it's like, it's also that term was called putting good money after bad.
I never heard that.
You never heard that before? No. Like, yeah, like, you know, it's almost like, I'll put it to you like this. You have a beat up car, and you know it's a piece of crap.
Mm.
And then you just keep pouring more money into
right,
it.
Right.
And then it dies completely. And it's like, now I'm going to put all this good money.
Right. Have I ever done that? Maybe. I don't know.
Probably not, man. Your car's like, I don't know, 200 years old.
Yeah, it is.
And it's still going.
Hey, listen, it just keeps on swimming.
It is swimming. It is swimming, I tell you that.
That's my little Dory.
All right, man.
So that's the power up inspirational quote of the week, people.
Yep, keep on pushing.
You are now watching Unapologetic Filmmaking and Dope.